all these events, a lot of events like Oka, Ipperwash, Caledonia, Idle No More. But there seems to be, after every crisis is solved, there's a collective memory loss by government, by everybody. So what's the roadmap going forward so that, you know, 2, 3, 5 years from now, we're not sitting here once again grilling you about the same thing, or your successor or whomever?
I think we've demonstrated a new roadmap over the past 5 years, one that is the difficult journey of reconciliation, one where we engage as partners with Indigenous communities and leadership and peoples to move forward on resolving historic land claims, on closing gaps between investments in provincial education systems per student and in Indigenous students, investing in infrastructure, housing, health services, and doing so in a way that puts Indigenous leadership at the center of that path forward. Reconciliation is a journey, and there are going to be difficult moments on that journey because it represents a significant shift in the way Canada works. But our capacity to work together requires us to engage, to, yes, recognize the historic wrongs, but to be present to fix them and move forward. That is what we will remain focused on. That is what we have focused on these past 2 weeks, and that is what I certainly hope we will continue to see, not just in the coming days, but in the coming months.
La Presse canadienne, puis ensuite National Post.
Presse canadienne and then the National Post.
Mr. Trudeau, you explained that you've been patient because you wanted to avoid an escalation, you wanted to avoid another Oka or Ipperwash. Can you tell me how you will be able to avoid another Oka and Ipperwash now that you have given a fairly clear signal to police to intervene? The signal is that we are still ready to have dialogue, but this signal is not only sent to those who are on the barricades or the hereditary chiefs of the Wet'suwet'en Nation, but also to all Indigenous leaders with whom we've been talking for 2 weeks now. We want to get back onto the positive path of reconciliation to ensure that non-Indigenous Canadians also see this path of reconciliation positively. We recognize that those who are on the barricades are not the unanimous voice within their communities. As a government, different levels of government, we have done an enormous amount to try to find a way to convince the people at the blockades to go to another step and to bring down those barricades. And now I think that it is up to Indigenous leaders to think about what they can do to put an end to the situation. So what you're saying is that if there is violence, if something goes wrong, if the worst possible imaginable outcome were to occur, it's the fault of Indigenous leaders? Quite the contrary. It would be lamentable, and everyone would lament it, Indigenous and non-Indigenous Canadians. But I am confident, I trust the professionalism and the ability of our law enforcement agents to work in the right way, to do the right thing. But I'm also confident that Indigenous leadership, which is not monolithic, that represents a vast number of voices within a community and across the country, wants to continue to be part of the solution. And I hope that we will see positive developments in the hours and days to come.
Prime Minister, you've talked about the time for dialogue. You've done all you can on dialogue. So what is next? Are you prepared to send in the RCMP to clear these blockades? And how will you manage if other blockades prop up in response?
I think we have demonstrated that we believe in a peaceful resolution to this, that we have demonstrated that engaging in respectful, substantive ways with Indigenous leadership that has expressed concerns is the path forward. And that is what we have done. But we cannot continue to watch Canadians suffer shortages and layoffs. The intervention in the case of the Tayendinega blockade is the responsibility of the Ontario Provincial Police. No order of government orders enforcement action or orders operational actions by police forces. We continue to be hopeful that the leadership within these Indigenous communities will find a way to bring down these barricades peacefully. But as a federal government, we have exhausted our capacity to engage in a positive, substantive, active way at our initiative to resolve this. And we will be, the onus is now shifted onto Indigenous leadership to look to continue this path of reconciliation in this difficult situation.
Shoot other public demands. They've asked for a meeting directly with you. They've asked for Coastal Gas to leave the project. Are you prepared to move on either of those demands?
We are always prepared to engage. We are always prepared to demonstrate the respect for hereditary leadership that is important to Indigenous peoples. But at the same time, there have been a series of different requests and different demands. One of the most clear ones was an ask to see the RCMP remove its command post on kilometre 29 of the access road. The RCMP independently, but in parallel to all our efforts, has made the decision to decommission that command post. That is a direct response to one of the clearest requests from the Wet'suwet'en hereditary leadership. And yet, that has not unlocked the end to the barricades that we had hoped it would be, or were hoping to see. We have therefore come to a moment where the onus is now on Indigenous leadership to end these barricades.
TVA, ensuite CBC.
Mr. Trudeau, you have said that the barricades must come down. When will they be removed, and when will trains be able to start up again? As I said, we are working with rail carriers to find alternatives so that there is not too much difficulties created for the Canadians who are suffering from shortages and losing jobs even. But we've reached the limit with regard to the impact on Canadians. And we're not just talking about an impact on the security of Canadians and Canadian communities. We're also talking about the impact on the reconciliation program. We've seen over the years that many Canadians realize that it is extremely important for our country to move forward with reconciliation and to create new positive relationships with Indigenous and Métis nations and the Inuit nation. And what is beginning to be at stake is the attitude of non-Indigenous Canadians toward reconciliation, and that would be extremely serious for our country to see Canadians closing their hearts to that important project for our country and for our future. Do you worry that police interventions may have explosive consequences in the various communities affected and that we'd end up with a problem that would become even worse? That's what has concerned us from the very beginning, and that's why we waited almost 2 weeks to get to this point where we are saying we've tried everything, we showed our initiative, our good faith, our will to resolve this problem peacefully and quickly. We are always there to work with Indigenous people, with Indigenous leaders as well. But we are at a point where it is up to Indigenous leaders, and I've spoken to a number of them over the last few days and last few weeks, and that's what they're saying. They're saying that the barricades are not helping to advance reconciliation or to advance the concerns of the leaders of the Wet'suwet'en Nation. But it is not up to the Government of Canada to speak for Indigenous peoples. It is up to them to explain why those barricades must come down or to explain why they have to stay up, which is inconceivable because Canadians are suffering. CBC and then the Devoir.
You mentioned that the onus is on Indigenous leadership to make sure, obviously, there's less conflict or violence as the barricades are being taken down. So if there is anything, any sort of conflict, are you saying it will be partly their fault?
No, I think all of us, Indigenous and non-Indigenous, want to see this situation resolved peacefully. We want to see Canada continue and improve the path of reconciliation we are on. For all that we have made progress over the past years, there is much more to do. There are many more wrongs to right, many more gaps to close. And it is on all of us to not just continue forward in a way that avoids further escalation or conflict, but that ensures that Canadians continue to remain full partners with Indigenous Canadians on this reconciliation journey.
You talked about some people attaching themselves to these protests, to the Wet'suwet'en issue. So what do you think the message of the protest is, the wider protest? What is it saying about what they're upset about?
I think there are many different angles and many different elements to the anxiety and the frustration that Canadians are feeling across the country. It is a time of anxiety that is manifesting itself in many different ways. In some countries, it's excesses of populism. In other countries, it's economic anxiety. What we're seeing a lot is both concern for Indigenous rights and title, which we agree with and we are very much working on, and concerns around the environment and the future for our kids and grandkids, which we are also very much engaged with and acting on. There are a lot of voices who want to be heard, to want to impact public opinion, and protests and demonstrations are an important tool in a democracy to highlight concerns that we have, that citizens have, and there's always room for them. But legally, in this case, the injunctions must be obeyed. The barricades must come down.
On a le devoir, puis après c'est le Toronto Star.
Le devoir, and then the Toronto Star. Mr. Trudeau, you have repeated that the barricades must come down, but that being said, up until now, the OPP has not acted. Sécurité du Québec hasn't acted either. The RCMP in British Columbia hasn't acted either in that direction. So what are you waiting for now? You're saying that the government can't order the police to act. Are you hoping that by speaking today in this way you are encouraging them to act? Would you think of sending in the army if the police doesn't act? First of all, there is no question of using the army. You do not use the army against Canadian civilians. Secondly, in British Columbia, the RCMP, acting as the provincial police under contract, intervened to ensure that the injunction was followed and removed the barricades over the last few weeks. With regard to the Ontario Provincial Police and the Quebec Provincial Police, that is a decision that they have to make. But as far as we know, as long as the government is showing progress and engaging to find a peaceful solution, they follow what we are doing and engage in their own processes. The decision that they make is theirs to make. So how can you guarantee to Canadians, and as you've said yourself, they're a bit exasperated, how can you guarantee to Canadians that the barricades will in fact be taken down if you yourself recognize that the police has to make its own decisions? Over the last week, over the last 2 weeks, I had many conversations with Indigenous leaders, and we can see that the media is starting to talk about that, and those conversations show solidarity with those who are expressing themselves about the deep-rooted problems that have been a fact in this country for decades and for centuries. But they are also saying that it is time for real dialogue and for real work together. It is time for the barricades to come down so that innocent Canadians all over the country aren't harmed. I believe that with conversations within Indigenous communities and after reflecting on everything we've shown as with regard to our willingness to work with the Wet'suwet'en and work with the Mohawk Nation to solve concerns that they have had for a very long time, we can do that without having to jeopardize the security of Canadians throughout the country. There are two questions more. Toronto Star and Radio-Canada.
Good afternoon, sir. Can you be quite explicit about what your message is to the BC RCMP officers listening to you right now, to the OPP commanders listening to you right now, and the SQ and police in Saint-Lambert? What is your message to the police officers?
My message is to everyone in Canada. My message is that injunctions must be obeyed, barricades must come down, but we must look to see this happen peacefully. We must look to be able to continue on this path of reconciliation that is not and will never be easy, but that requires a partnership and a trust that needs to be built on positive actions. There will always be moments of difficulty, but we need to be able to work through it together. And I am hopeful that Indigenous leadership over the coming hours and day will see that in order to continue on this peaceful and important path, those barricades need to come down.
So that's all in the passive voice, and they don't magically pop down by themselves. So what's your message to the police officers who you've just essentially said have a responsibility to take down barricades to move propane in the next couple of days?
I did not say that. The responsibility of law enforcement in this country is to keep the peace and ensure that laws are enforced, and indeed to enforce those laws. How they do that, and when they do that, is part of their responsibility and their professionalism, and no politician gets to say, you need to do this now, this way. That's not how our country works.
Dernière question.
Bonjour, Christian Noël de Radio-Canada.
Christian Noël, Radio Canada, you're here at the podium, you're calm, you're saying enough is enough, but you're not making any concrete moves. You're just saying that it's up to the Indigenous peoples, it's up to law enforcement, but what is your responsibility and what must you do? We have been acting in a concrete way for 2 weeks to continue the dialogue and to show through concrete action that we are here to work on reconciliation and to listen to the concerns of the Wet'suwet'en chiefs and others. We have worked with rail carriers to find alternatives to minimize the impact on the security of Canadians and the shortages of propane, for example. We have worked with Indigenous peoples to find concrete solutions. We have engaged in dialogue. We have shown openness at each step while calling publicly for calm. These are very local issues in British Columbia. It's a gas pipeline. It's a provincial gas pipeline that was approved through a provincial process. The negotiations that are going on with the Wet'suwet'en Nation communities regarding their land and their rights, those negotiations are happening at a provincial table. In Belleville, in Tiendanaga, it's the provincial police that's in charge of ensuring security in that situation. It would be very possible for a federal government to say, oh, those are provincial issues. Good luck in trying to resolve the problems that you have. But that is not what we did. We chose to recognize that, yes, it is a national issue. It originates in a province, and there are severe impacts in another province, in Ontario and in Quebec. And therefore, the federal government took the step of being deeply engaged in the path toward reconciliation and a peaceful solution. And we continue to be open to that. But I must recognizing that today, we have done everything that we have been able to do to come to this, to a solution, to arrive at an agreement. And now, I hope that within Indigenous communities themselves, they will be able to see that the goodwill of the federal government and of all the provinces is present. We are there to be partners, but we cannot continue to be there if the barricades stay up. How can you talk about action if you cannot say when Canadians are going to be able to see railway transportation come back? We have taken concrete steps in the last few days, the last two or three days, to ensure that we are minimizing the disruptions to rail transportation by finding alternatives and using those alternatives. But we recognize that even with those alternatives in place, there are real concerns with regard to Canadians' safety and the safety of their communities. So, we are doing that to minimize the impact, but we are also trying to create the conditions for a peaceful resolution of this crisis. This speech today is also aimed at explaining and expressing our willingness to find a peaceful solution and to find a way forward in partnership and with respect. But that we have reached the limit of what we have been able to do unilaterally as the federal government. And now it is up to Indigenous leaders to find solutions to continue on the path of reconciliation in a positive way for all Canadians, Indigenous Canadians and non-Indigenous Canadians. Thank you.